Hey guys, check it out. The parade started.
Stay tuned for all the fun, excitement, and Christmas cheer of the 1990 Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade from the Magic Kingdom in Florida. Live from the Walt Disney World Resort in Florida, a Disney Christmas Spectacular. With season's greetings to all of America, Canada, South America, Europe, plus servicemen and women around the world. It's the 8th annual Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. Join your hosts Joan Lunden and Alan Thicke, along with Regis Philbin at Walt Disney World in Florida, and from Disneyland in California, Sarah Purcell. Special guest star from Family Matters, Jaleel White, featuring Amy Grant in a coast-to-coast Disney Christmas celebration. Join your parade hosts, Mickey Mouse.
Hiya, folks.
Minnie Mouse.
Merry Christmas.
And the whole Disney gang. Catch the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles on parade. Say hello to Bernard and Bianca. Join country music star Lee Greenwood in a musical tribute to the men and women of the armed forces. Receive Christmas wishes from America's courageous troops stationed in the Middle East. And catch all the magic and excitement of the 1990 Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade, including magnificent floats, your favorite Disney characters, and lots of holiday surprises.
Have a holly jolly Christmas.
When you big walk down the street,
say hello to the virgin gold with everyone you meet.
Oh, oh, the mistletoe hung where you can see. Somebody waits for you.
Yes, sir, one for me.
Have a holly jolly Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, oh my golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year.
The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade, brought to you by Kissimmee St. Cloud, Florida, the vacation destination in the middle of Central Florida's best attractions. Location is our biggest attraction. And Johnson & Johnson, where quality products for the American family have been a tradition for generations. And irresistibly, squeezably soft Charmin. Everybody loves a little squeeze.
Merry Christmas, everyone, and welcome to the 8th annual Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. I'm Joan Lunden.
Yes, and I'm Alan Thicke, and Merry Christmas live from the Magic Kingdom. We have a beautiful day here in sunny Florida, as you would expect, and a magnificent parade ahead. Plus, of course, everyone's favorite elf, Regis Philbin, down on Main Street, USA. Let's check in with Regis.
Hi, Alan. How you doing, Joan? Merry Christmas, everybody. You know, I've been coming down here so long that I guess I got my own little fan club here. Look what I found right here. What is your name?
Mindy Firestone.
And what parade is this from?
The Easter Parade.
You guys don't miss a parade down here, do you?
No.
Nice to have you here, Mindy. Are you her father, right?
Yes, Alan Firestone from Scranton, PA.
Scranton, PA?
Mm-hmm. Good. Just thought I'd let you know, we have two favorite Disney characters. Yeah. Mickey Mouse and Regis Philbin.
How do you like that?
Hey!
I know Regis Philbin, but who's the other guy?
Yeah. He's the guy with the big ears.
Nice to see everybody. Merry Christmas, Mickey. I love when everybody gets dressed up this way.
Merry Christmas.
Yeah. Merry Christmas.
Nice to see you. From Canada, good. Yes, all the balloons are here. Wait a minute. Here's one guy, came all the way from New Hampshire. New Hampshire snow. No, no, no. Disney World Christmas.
Ho, ho, ho.
There you go. All right, is everybody ready for a parade?
Yeah!
Let's get started now. Here comes the University of Central Florida marching band. Right here.
Thank you.
only 10 years old, but already it's received national recognition for some very innovative shows. In fact, the Marching Knights are hoping to become leaders in halftime programming.
That's right. They're good. Someday they'll be a full-time halftime band. These students not only play the instrument, they also play a major role as the creators of their musical performances. Most of the shows are written and designed by the students themselves, who come from all over Florida and as far away as New York.
There's your shot up Main Street this morning with Cinderella's castle in the background. This is really a place where so many young people, you know, Alan, get their start.
Lots of work if you play a tuba here.
And just behind the Marching Knights this morning, we will be kicking off the parade. And
yes,
there the Elves are officially kicking off the Very Merry Christmas Parade this morning.
The hardest working elves in show business, ladies and gentlemen. They make toys, they do Santa's flight plan, then they have to come here, they're into hair and makeup, boom, in a parade, just like that.
You can see there the knights on horseback.
Mm-hmm. Decked out for the holidays in that casual coat of mail look. Yeah, show me something in a nice suit of armor next year.
Well, that's the fashion of the era, at least,
yeah,
in the storybooks. A very chivalrous bunch,
uh-huh,
don't you think?
Something that won't clash with the moat. Very colorful.
Now, the guys there in the bright blue, that's the Royal Guard, another striking group. I like a man in uniform, you know?
Mm-hmm.
These guys, though, they always kind of signal the way of Cinderella and the whole group.
That means she can't be far behind.
Look at that shot. As you can see, it is a spectacular day today. Hey, look who's
look
there,
who's
Mickey
here.
And Minnie Mouse.
And look who else is
and
there.
And look who else. They are accompanied this morning. I see Jamie and Lindsay and little Sarah, my three little girls.
Yes, they've been here so many times. They are the official children of Disney World, folks. They get more close-ups than Sleeping Beauty around here, Joan.
Well, they feel pretty special this morning up there with Mickey and Minnie.
Looking beautiful.
Look at the other characters there on the float. Pluto. I imagine he got a nice big bone for Christmas.
Bonus bone.
Little Mickey and Minnie, you know, they met in 1928 in the cartoon Steamboat Willie. They've had a nice marriage all these years.
And they said it wouldn't last. What do mice know that people don't?
Oh, look who else is there on that float. Sleeping Beauty and Prince Philip and the three good fairies. Isn't that Merryweather up there? There's Merryweather and Flora and Fauna, the three good fairies.
There's your Christmas tradition.
You know, that's Major Mike, and
Major.
Those are the fanfare trumpeters, and Major Mike has been here every year since this parade started 8 years ago. He's got 26 musicians that he's leading there. He really is part of the tradition here at Christmas time.
Major Mike has some major moves this year, doesn't he? So smooth. Very graceful. Beautiful costumes, beautiful day.
You can see the people lined along each side of the street there. They start pouring in here early in the morning to get a good position.
The court dancers, very graceful, elegant. This is the kind of dancing you saw in the music videos of those days.
Yes.
MTV, the medieval television. These are the moves.
Well, these folks are all part of Cinderella's court. So we will see the lovely little lady in a moment. I don't imagine any of these are her ugly stepsisters. You remember their names? Anastasia and Drizella.
Drizella. You say Drizella.
And here she comes. It took the Disney Studios 6 years to make this movie. Look at her. Isn't she beautiful?
She is. And they're blowing a kiss. Right.
All the little girls love it when Cinderella comes by.
Having a magic wand would be nice for Christmas, wouldn't it? It's kind of like a credit card. You just poof, you pick out a pumpkin, you drive it home. Merry Christmas.
Christmas is traditionally a time for families to spend together, yet There are thousands of people watching this morning who cannot be sharing this day with their loved ones. They are military servicemen and women stationed away from home, many in foreign countries, of course, this time.
Mickey's very Merry Christmas Parade is televised through the Armed Forces Network this year to over 100 military bases around the world, including those in Saudi Arabia.
And last week, the Disney crew went over to Saudi Arabia to find out how the troops are spending their Christmas and to bring back some very special messages. Plus, here at home, Disney hosted some holiday gatherings for families of the troops in Saudi.
Operation Desert Shield family parties were held by both Disneyland and Walt Disney World for the children, husbands, and wives of Saudi troops who live in Southern California and Florida. They were invited to share a little Christmas cheer with the Disney characters and enjoy all the Magic Kingdom attractions. One of the highlights for all was the AT&T complimentary fax machine, sending lots of loving messages.
Hi, Dad, and I miss you. And Christmas isn't going to be the way it used to be in the past years. And Merry Christmas, and I hope you come home real soon.
We love you. We want you home soon.
We miss you, and we wish
you were home. We all miss you, Dad. I love you, Dad. Love you.
I miss you. Have a Merry Christmas, and I'll be home real soon. I'll be home soon. It won't quite be for Christmas, but it won't be long after that.
Daddy, I love you.
My name is Todd Radford, and I would like to thank all the people of America for all the gifts and the care and concern that you've shown us. Other than a plane ticket home, that's probably the best Christmas gift you could have given us and myself. And I'd like to thank my family for all their concern, too. Merry Christmas, all.
And we are back in Disney World, Florida, a live shot from the MetLife blimp. You're looking at the Grand Floridian Hotel there.
The warm and wonderful Grand Floridian. There are parts of this country that need some antifreeze in the eggnog this morning, but not here.
And we have Captain Bill Steeser and Captain Bart Van Beest are piloting today. Welcome back, everyone, to the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
So much happening down on the street. And let's take a look now. Wreaths galore.
The world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more did you looking for?
And look who is here. This is Ariel, Sebastian, and all of America's favorite Disney characters from The Little Mermaid.
And the Oscar-winning song, best song, Under the Sea.
Down you for the fish is happy as up through the waves go. The fish on the land ain't happy. It's hard 'cause they in the bowl. But fish in the bowl is lucky. They in for a worse of fate. One day when the boss get hungry,
yes, you go beyond the pay.
What go under the sea? Under the sea. Nobody beat us, fry us, and eat us in fricassee. We watching land folks loves to cook. Under the sea, we after hook. We got no troubles. Life is the bubbles under the sea. Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Seems like it's sweet here. We got to be here naturally. Even the sturgeon and the ray, they did the earth and start to play. We got the spirit. You got to hear it under the sea. The
chop, play the hop, the players play the bass, and they sound the chop, the bass play the brass, the chop play the top. The flute is the duke of soul. The way he can play the names on the strings, the chop rocking on the black fish, he sings his belt and his rat. They know where it's at, they know that blowfish blow.
Well, it's a show now, I'll tell you. And there's look little Pinocchio here. And Jiminy Cricket.
Jiminy Cricket, of course, was Pinocchio's conscience. Tough to find a good conscience these days.
That's old Blue Fairy appointed him as Pinocchio's conscience.
Mm-hmm. Jiminy then became a regular on the Mickey Mouse Club, remember that?
That's right. You know, during the making of that movie, at one point they scrapped 5 months' worth of work and started all over again.
And all the characters, like Stromboli and Foul Fellow and Wicked Stromboli and, a lot of very unusual characters from
got old Pinocchio, into a lot of trouble.
Sort of the Twin Peaks of its time.
Well, Santa's elves vacationing at Walt Disney World during Christmas is kind of becoming one of those annual Christmas traditions for us.
Like
last year they were over at Disney's Typhoon Lagoon, which is a huge new 55-acre water park. Well, this year they are enjoying Disney's new Yacht and Beach Club Resort.
Well, even elves need a little Disney fun in the sun. Let's go see what they've been up to over at Disney's newest resort.
Christmas time, 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 Christmas time,
It's Honey, I Shrunk Regis Philbin when the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade continues.
We're the men from CSSD 111 El Mako. We'd like to wish all of you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas!
Back to Christmas morning in Orlando, Florida. That's a live shot once again from the MetLife blimp.
Not blimp, it's a full-size balloon.
Nobody wants to be called a blimp, huh?
Merry Christmas, everybody. The first Christmas morning of the 90s.
That's right, 1990.
Yes, we can. I wonder how different it'll be by the year 2000. More expensive, maybe? Get your mortgage on a big turkey for the year 1999. Get it now. Look what we have on the street. More action, more color.
I see Winnie the Pooh out there and Tigger, too.
You can hardly see the forest for the bears down there.
There's little Winnie the Pooh. Edwin Bear, as he's known more formally. Hey, there's Eeyore, too. You know, Eeyore's a pessimist, and he always thinks no one notices him. So Merry Christmas, Eeyore.
Now, who was the optimist? And that was Tigger.
That's right. Well, he's got that springy tail that keeps bouncing all the time, where Eeyore, he has to tack his on, you know.
I hate it when that happens.
Don't you just hate it when that happens? The snowmen are out there, too. Look at that.
Merry Christmas!
Now, what about Kanga?
Kanga's right over there on top of the
float.
See him? Little Roo peeking out of her pouch.
Along for a free ride.
And the wise guy, the owl. There's a close up of Kanga and Little Roo. Now, just behind Pooh is, look at that.
That's right, at the other end of the forest.
White. And all of her little friends. A kiss from her Prince Charming.
You saw it here first, folks. And the seven dwarfs.
Well, they're all down there, so we're safe to just start naming.
Yes, there's Doc down there. It's always so tough for me.
Grumpy
and Lumpy and Doogie.
No, Sneezy.
Sleppy, Beano, Frosty, and Bo.
Bashful, Dopey, and Sleepy. When this movie was first opened, I think it was about 25 years ago, it broke all box office records. I took my little girls to Radio City Music Hall where it first opened.
Mm-hmm.
And we went there a couple of years ago. Hey, there's Sleepy on the back.
How can you sleep through a parade like this? Only Sleepy can do it. A wonderful family, Snow and her seven dwarfs, one of the earliest examples of codependency.
Look at that shot of the castle. Hey, a country Christmas. Those are the country bears. Wendell,
Liverlips, and Shaker, my lawyers.
They're always performing over there at the Country Bear Hoedown, but this time of year they've also got a big Christmas show.
Yes, if you watch carefully, you'll see scarecrows and clogger girls clogging up the street there, and I mean that in the nicest way.
A hootin' and a hollerin'.
Yeah, country Christmas. Listen.
Try to keep your foot from moving, huh?
I couldn't do it. A lot of stomping and romping and good times going on down there.
the Country Cloggers. But a lot of energy there. And speaking of energy, Regis used just about all of his up the other day over at the Disney MGM Studios theme park. Seems he got lost in the magic of movie special effects, and he thought he'd never get out. And it turned out to be quite an adventure. Let's watch what happened.
Joan Allen, hi everybody. I'm here at the backstage tour of the Disney MGM Studios theme park, where you see all the magic of TV shows and motion pictures in the making. Lots of times, special effects provide the magic and the fun. For example, what could be better than one Regis? How about two Regis? Better yet, three Regis. Hey, we could stage a mega Regis spectacular.
Yeah, and I get to play the leading role.
No, I do. I'm better looking than you are. You kidding? You guys are ugly compared to me. Whoa. I think we better get back to reality, guys. Which one of us is reality? I don't know. Let's see who shows up in the next scene. Boy, thank goodness it's me. Hey, it looks like I've been zapped right into the middle of the backstage tour.
Hey, Mr. Regis. Is that the bee from the Honey, I Shrunk the Kids movie?
Sure looks like it, kid. Hey, what do you say you and I go for a ride?
Yeah.
Hey, how about a lift, guys, okay?
Through the magic of blue screen, we'll videotape these guys on the bee, then place the shot in another backyard scene. The outcome is really hair-raising.
Ready when you are, Mr. Philbin.
You ready to go, kid?
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
Okay, roll the background film.
Help! Help!
Wait a minute, I got you! Oh! Hey! Go! Nice ride, Mr. Regis. Where are we now?
Well, I'm afraid we shrunk, kid. And this looks like the backyard.
Gosh, everything here is really huge. Look at the size of that paperclip.
Don't worry, a big star like me isn't going to play a small part like this for very long. I'll get us out of here. Come on. Hey, what is this? Look. A rope ladder. We'll climb out.
No, it looks like a spider's web.
Spider's web? I hate spiders. Come on, let's go.
Hey, Mr. Regis, I think I found your aunt.
My aunt looks more like your uncle. Come on.
Wow, a giant Lego.
I wish they had toys like this when I was a kid.
How long ago was that?
None of your business. Never mind. Come on. Kid, wait. Where are you going?
Cereal. I'm hungry.
Cereal, yuck. Come on.
Come on, Mr. Regis. Follow me.
I've heard of being in buildings before, but this is ridiculous.
Whoa. Oh, that was fun, Mr. Regis. Want to go again?
Are you kidding? Never. It's a jungle in there.
No, it's not. It's just Disney's new Honey, I Shrunk the Kids movies and adventure. It's only a giant playground for kids of all ages. Even you, Mr. Regis.
Don't you think I knew that? I knew that.
Stay where you are, the teacher of the year, plus a special Christmas salute from Lee Greenwood, coming up next.
Hi, I'm Marjorie Judith Vincent, Miss America 1991, wishing everyone a Merry Christmas.
All right, here I am, all grown up again after my tour of Honey, I Shrunk the Kids, which is Disney's newest attraction. Incidentally, quite a place to bring the kids. Here's Opie right here. Did you ever see a face like that? Anyway, we're back here on the parade route. And you know, there are a lot of school kids here, a lot of school children. But are there any teachers here today? Yes. So important teachers are. Yes, sir, where do you teach?
I teach in Brick, New Jersey at Brick Memorial High School.
What subject?
Mathematics.
I teach math, junior high in the NASA area of Houston, Texas.
I teach at Mohawk High School in Bessemer, Pennsylvania. I teach senior general science.
Do you all know how important you are?
Yes, sir, we sure do.
It's a very serious job, it really is. What about you?
I teach music at Keister Elementary School in Harrisonburg, Virginia.
Well, that's great. Well, listen, today we have a special holiday salute to all the teachers watching. You know, Disney has long been committed to education in this country, supporting teacher merit awards and student scholarship programs and so forth. One of the newest and biggest undertakings is the annual Teacher of the Year National Award Ceremony. Michael Eisner, my good friend Michael Eisner, chairman of the board of the Walt Disney Company, is here to tell us all about it. Thank you very much, and have
Michael
a nice
Eisner,
time today.
And Merry Christmas to you. This morning, I'd like to pay my personal respects to our nation's school teachers. They are the people who dedicate their careers to educating our children. And to me, education is one of the greatest gifts any child can receive. In appreciation of teachers, the Disney Company recently held the first nationally televised ceremony of the American Teachers Awards and presented over $250,000 to 36 outstanding educators. The teachers themselves selected Mrs. Sylvia Washburn to be the Outstanding Teacher of 1990. As the first to hold this prestigious title, Sylvia sets an outstanding example for all future honorees in the annual American Teacher Awards. I'm proud to say Sylvia and her family are with us in our parade this morning. She joins me and all the Disney cast members in wishing you and your family the happiest of holidays. Now let's get back to Sylvia and our Merry Christmas Parade.
And there she is live and with us this Christmas morning, the Teacher of the Year, Mrs. Sylvia Washburn from Toledo, Ohio.
Yeah, I got an opportunity to meet her and her family just before the parade. That's her husband, Miles, her two sons, Evan and Alex. And I'll bet that all the students watching from Mrs. Washburn's third grade class at Marshall School, that they're very proud, don't you think?
Yes, and probably this morning doing their geometry problems. You gotta be tough to be Teacher of the Year. My dad always thought that the Teacher of the Year was the one who put up with me.
Hey, look what's following Mrs. Washburn. It's the Calliope. And that Calliope, I think, has been in this parade ever since we first started, too.
It was built in London, England, in 1907. Walt had it with him on the opening day of Disneyland, and that was more than 35 years ago. Playing a Christmas medley.
This is a showboat. Now, I always love this float because it's the biggest float, tallest float in the parade, except usually there's some crowns up there on top of those smokestacks. They actually had to take the crowns off so that the float could make it down Main Street underneath all the garlands.
I thought I'd
Donald and Lucy. I thought I'd seen
everything driving on the freeways in L.A., but a riverboat coming down the street with a pair of ducks. Now, how long have Donald and Daisy been together? I think
50 years, and you would never know it. I mean, they just look great. And happy couple.
The Miami Springs High School Band, you will see soon. Now, they're kind of special because both Disneyland and Walt Disney World, you know, invite young musicians from all around the country, and they come and perform during Magic Music Days.
And they're not just high school bands, they're also orchestras, ensembles, jazz, concert ensembles, all kinds of young entertainers, dance groups.
Mm-hmm. And these are the first place winners, the Miami Springs High School Band, in the All Florida Festival of Bands, hosted by Walt Disney World this year.
So it's an honor for them to be representing all the other groups who participated from all over the country. More young bands in the parade this year than we ever had. It's really nice.
Well, and to be a first place winner, of course, among all those bands is an honor for the Miami Springs High School. Now we're going to take you to super talented country singer Lee Greenwood, and he has some special music for you.
Yes, because the song is dedicated to our American troops over in the Persian Gulf who are here with us this morning, if only in our hearts and our dreams.
Snow and mistletoe and presents on
Hi, America. I'm Corporal Bob Joubert from Saudi Arabia. I'd like to introduce you to the newest member of my family. This is my baby girl, Rachel. She was born November 19th of this year. This is my wife, Diana. As far as I could see, she's about the best Christmas present I could have gotten while I was here. Diana, I'm sorry I can't be with you, but I hope you have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year anyway. And hopefully I'll be there next year. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everyone. You're looking at a live shot of Epcot Center. That's Spaceship Earth there, right?
The world's largest golf ball, I think.
And as you can see, it's a beautiful day here in Orlando.
Yes.
We are back with a terrific parade from the Walt Disney World Resort.
We have some surprises. I have a surprise even for you, Joan.
You don't know about this. Well, give me a hint.
Well, I'll tell you that I used to be with a band called the Stone Age Mutant Ninja Tortoises long ago. I have some new turtle friends. That's on
top. Donatello?
I don't tell you nothing, right?
Oh.
Now you gotta watch.
Hey, look who's there. It's Kristen Larson. She's the little girl who stars with Minnie and Me, that new album. She's a cutie pie.
Let's hear her sing. Oh, come on, Krista. Well, maybe she's not in the mood.
I'll let you in on a little backstage secret. My kids think it's pretty neat because she has a little button there that she can make herself go up and down and right and left, and they think that's pretty cool.
And she's on an entire toy factory there, too.
Yeah.
Kids love that. I used to ask for everything. I spent enough time on Santa's lap that my dad used to have to rent space there. Sprained Santa's lap one Christmas. Of course, here on Main Street, with all the shops, you can do a lot of your last-minute Christmas shopping.
And a lot of people do it, too. Hey, look, there's the elephant from Jungle Book. There's a lot of dancing toys back here.
King
there's Leonidas, yes. And there are the monkeys. And I think I saw Raggedy Ann and Andy out there.
I want a train, but not the track. The team away and then come back.
Hey, that's the toy train. Did you like
that? Roger Rabbit. Well, I did. As I said, I asked for everything. I didn't get it all, of course, but I used to go from store to store, knowing Santa would keep moving around and I could ask.
Look who's driving.
That looks like
Goofy.
Yeah.
Well, he's pretty good at a lot of different sports. I don't know if he's a good driver, though.
I saw Roger Rabbit on the train. No wonder he looked a little hyper the way Goofy.
He's always hyper. I want a train and guns right now. Oh, look at him. He's so cute. The kids really love it when he comes around. That's one of the most colorful units. The people down on the street love that. And Disney has been doing some great new stuff with animated movies in recent years. The current release is, of course, The Rescuers Down Under.
Yes, big hit movie. And some of the animation for that release was done right here at the Disney MGM Studios in Florida. Let's take a look now behind the scenes.
Which way are you taking? Suicide Trail through Nightmare Canyon or the shortcut at Satan's Ridge?
Suicide Trail?
Good choice. More snakes, less quicksand.
With the release of The Rescuers Down Under, I think we have now solidly set on course to achieve our original goal that we set 6 years ago, which was to make a new animated feature each year. And when you add to that the first new piece of Mickey Mouse animation in The Prince and the Pauper as part of a double bill attraction this season, we've surpassed even our wildest dreams.
Wait a minute. I don't see any of that stuff on the map.
I was a longtime fan of Bob Newhart's, and also Green Acres was one of my favorite shows of all time. So the fact that Ava Gabor and Bob Newhart are involved, I love their voices. I couldn't wait to animate Bob Newhart in any kind of a scene.
Yeah, it's just a little bumpy.
bumpy back here.
Well, that's terrible. We gotta do something. Well,
Wilbur's another tremendous support in the film because he was cast with a character, John Candy, who is so inherently funny. He's just, he's a guy that is just, there are rare people in the world who just are funny.
There's ways remaining seated until the aircraft comes to a full and complete stop.
We'll never make it.
Well, there's no question that we maybe bit off even a little bit more than we could chew in trying to do both a feature in this, get one finished in this year, and do a featurette on top of it. And the Florida facility became a very important contributor to that.
When our little group was starting out with the Prince and the Pauper, we found ourselves working with a small crew because the main crew was animating rescuers down under, down the street. So we thought, well, we need some help here. And thank goodness there was the Florida studio across the country with some very fine, refined animators, and we just yelled and screamed and said, please, help us out with this Mickey Mouse footage.
Oh, am I glad to see you. I mean, what a time I've...
The important thing to remember is everybody that's here is here to make this a functioning studio. I mean, we're used to having 10,000 people a day come through the building and see our work. But the important thing is we're here to work, and we're here to really make this studio something very special.
Throw another shrimp in a Barbie, girls, because here I come!
Here we go again!
Cannonball!
And look who is riding on Santa's workshop float. It's the stars of Disney's 29th animated release, The Rescuers, Bernard and Bianca, or as she would prefer to be called, Miss Bianca.
Yes, or Ms. Bianca.
And she, of course, is a member of the International Rescue Aid Society, who, along with her sometimes reluctant partner, Bernard, is always trying to save someone.
Well, they did a fine job down under, which, of course, is Australia. They saved a young boy and an eagle named Marabuti. Sure, your girls love this one.
Oh, absolutely. They went just recently.
Lots more to love, and we'll be right back. Stay with us.
Next up, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles with a rap and roll Christmas carol.
Hi, I'm Gloria Estefan, and obviously Mickey and Minnie, and we want to wish you all a very Merry Christmas from Walt Disney World.
The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade will continue in a moment. Patadol Name. Caring isn't just what we do, it's who we are. And Crisco Shortening. For light and flaky pie crusts, crispy fried chicken, and moist and chewy cookies, Crisco is the recipe for success. And Kissimmee St. Cloud, Florida, the vacation destination in the middle of Central Florida's best attractions. Location is our biggest attraction.
Welcome back, everyone, to Christmas morning in Orlando, Florida. You are looking at the Disney MGM studio there from the blimp. Yes, he can fly a long way, over 28,000 acres here of Disney World. We're here in the Magic Kingdom this morning in Florida, and I'm afraid I'm all alone right now. Alan Thicke has temporarily disappeared, but I suspect he might reappear where we least expect him very, very soon, because we've got a great show planned for the remainder of the morning. In fact, right now, I think I hear some familiar dudes rolling in on Main Street, USA. So let's go down and see what all the commotion's about. Cowabunga, it looks like the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, and look who's joined the party.
Everybody ready to party?
Thank you.
because Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is back in town.
I never knew that Alan was such a radically cool dude. That was awesome. But look what's following behind. Another cool dude, Herbie. I always like Herbie the love bug. He's totally out of control. Sticking his tongue out there at the Elves. This morning, of course, he has a big red ribbon on top. How'd you like to find that under your Christmas tree? Those Elves are taking their lives in their hands this morning. We got a colorful bunch of clowns. Maybe we'll find Alan down here again. Look at all the costumes there. Disney makes almost all of their costumes for the movies, the shows, all these parades. In fact, it's one of the world's largest working wardrobes right here in Walt Disney World. In fact, now you can go on the backstage tour over at the Disney MGM Studios theme park, and you can actually see the costume makers at work. Seeing humongous toy blocks, colorful clowns, elves, all sorts of jovial Disney characters this morning. And there's plenty more to come, but right now, on a more serious note, the Disney crew went over to the Persian Gulf last week to see how the troops are spending their Christmas, and they discovered that most of the servicemen and women are doing their part to try to create a feeling of Christmas away from home. One of the groups had musicians together, and they provided the Christmas music. Decorations were being hung to create the atmosphere. And the troops stayed busy writing cards and poems. They talked about holidays past spent with their families, and they were anxious to send messages back home. As much as these men and women are missing their families this Christmas, they are keeping the spirit of the holidays alive over in the Persian Gulf.
Saudi. It's almost Christmas, and I want to send this card to you to let you know that I love you and I miss everybody back in New York. Love, your son, Dave.
Warmest holiday wishes to Lushan, my son. I love you. Lushan, I really miss you. I'll be home soon, as soon as I can. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year's.
Dear Moore and Tara, I love you very much and we'll see you sometime soon. We'll be together next Christmas. Love, always and forever. Love, Mom. P.S. We'll make Christmas cookies when I get home, whenever that is. Love and kisses.
Dear Mom and Dad, I sure hope all is going well for you. Things here are much the same as always. I wish I could be there with you for this holiday season, but I've got a job to do. I'm doing well and hope to be home real soon. Your ever-loving son, Tyler.
Meaning for Christmas for me is you should be home during Christmas and so I get together with your family because it's not the place to be during the holiday.
I've been over here in Saudi Arabia for about 4 months now. About a week prior to leaving, I was scheduled to go visit my fiancée to propose to her and had a slight change of plan with the recent situation over here. I had her fly down to meet me and I proposed to her a week before we left. This was planning to be my most memorable Christmas so I could spend it with her, but obviously I'm not going to be able to make it home, so I'm planning to take her to Disney World as soon as I get because that's her favorite place in the whole world and that's where she wants to go. So, Christine, I promise you when we get home, we're going to Disney World as soon as I get off the plane.
Welcome back, everyone, and welcome back, Alan. Great parade going on out there.
Oh, we're having a good old time, and we'll be returning with a spectacular Walt Disney World parade finale. But right now, we're going to go over to California and join Disneyland parade hosts Sarah Purcell and Jaleel White. Merry Christmas, Sarah. Merry Christmas, Jaleel.
Thank you, Joan and Alan, and a very Merry Christmas to you in Florida, and to all of you at home. A Merry Christmas to you, Jaleel.
Oh, thank you. The more the merrier.
We're perched high above Main Street on this beautiful morning, and there's an exciting feeling of Christmas all around us as we prepare for the very Merry Christmas Parade. Right now, though, we need to make way for six outstanding California marching bands as they bring Christmas in with a bang.
There's major Christmas cheer here at Disneyland, so hold on to your eggnog because here we go.
Everyone knows that great bands and stunning parades are a Disneyland tradition.
And we have six bands in six lands to help us kick off the Disneyland Very Merry Christmas Parade. Hey, let's go out to the carousel where the highly acclaimed UCLA marching band is giving us a sweet beat.
Under the direction of Gordon Henderson and looking snappy in their blue and gold uniforms, they're belting out Strike Up the Band.
Let's cruise over to Splash Mountain, where director David Barron has his Bloomington High School band making some waves.
The present meets the future. The Catella High School Band is playing a melody we can all agree with. Don't Rain on My Parade.
Over in Frontierland, we've got the Capistrano Valley High School marching band.
Not to be outdone, director Danny Witherspoon has his Arroyo High School band doing a bravura job with the European March Bravura. Easing into the smooth jazz tones of New York afternoon. It's the 99-member Mission Viejo High School Band. Now, in honor of the Christmas spirit, these six magnificent bands are coming together on Main Street, USA to welcome the season with a majestic Christmas medley. So let's listen. Disneyland banner announcing the start of the magic and saluting the season are the fanfare trumpeters and the royal band. Coming up fast is the Peter Pan float.
We always make this trip to crook what we can crook. We
Looks like our favorite flying boy has got his hands full with those pirates. Here comes Wendy, John, and Michael following the Lost Boys. And we'll be back with more of the Disneyland Very Merry Christmas Parade.
À tous les enfants du monde,
to all the children of the world, I would like to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. A year of peace and a year of greater solidarity between the rich and the poor in the world. Finally, a year in which the young can hope to build a better world for tomorrow. Happy New Year!
Hello again, everybody. I'm Sarah Purcell, and this is a very special Christmas as Disneyland celebrates its 35th Christmas here in Southern California. Sauntering up Main Street now is the Alice in Wonderland Brigade. Leading the charge is a woman with a serious attitude problem, the Queen of Hearts. This is my favorite, the caterpillar and the shining, beautiful butterfly.
How do you get to Wonderland? Over the hill or underland, or just behind the tree? When clouds go rolling by, they run away and leave the sky.
And here's our gem, Alice, looking sprightly in her golden locks and white dress.
Where can it be? Where do the stars go? Where is the precious moon?
Even at Christmas, in Disneyland, it feels like spring. With a little help from Tinkerbell, we're going to whisk away to the musical world of Amy Grant. Can you smell the chestnuts roasting? It must be Christmas.
Lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh.
spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering just a wish to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to you.
Month, 30 days, my wife will expect her second child. Even though I'm over here far, far away, I know I have a job to do, and I'm proud to do it, and I will do it well. I'd just like to say to America, God bless you all. To wife Paula, I love you and miss you. I'm gonna be home soon. God bless you all. Happy New Year.
Purcell, and this is a very special Christmas. It's the most supercalifragilistic expialidocious nanny in the world, Mary Poppins. Mary Poppins was one of Walt Disney's crowning achievements and garnered 5 Academy Awards. Walt Disney himself said, "I can never build another Fantasia." And truly, even 50 years after its initial release, it stands as a singular achievement of sight and sound. Well, now we get a look at the hottest thing to hit Disney since Roger Rabbit. It's the stars of the Disney afternoon.
Step right up and come on in. Here's where the fun begins. There's so much to do. Get it ready just for you. Everybody's busy bringing you a Disney afternoon. Hey! Can you feel the buzz? Well, you're gonna feel the buzz because everybody's busy. Just a little busy. Bringing you a Disney afternoon. Camera action light. You won't believe the sounds and sights. We got spills, we got thrills and more. Get set, ready, go. You know we're putting on a show. Get the paint, grab a brush, and you can join the rush. Oh, there's so much to do, get it ready just for you. Everybody's busy, bringing you a Disney afternoon. Hey, can you feel the buzz? Well, you're gonna feel the buzz because everybody's busy, just a little busy, bringing you a Disney afternoon.
everybody's busy bringing you a Disney afternoon. Hey, there's so much to do, getting ready just for you. Everybody's busy bringing you a Disney afternoon. Hey, can't you feel the buzz? Don't you know you feel the buzz? Because everybody's busy, just a little dizzy, bringing you a Disney.
As the Christmas float nears and the snowflakes gather, enjoy the sounds of the season and the gorgeous finale float.
We're happy tonight, walking in a winter wonderland. Gone away is the bluebird, here's Jay, the new bird. He sings us a song as we go along, walking in a winter wonderland. In the meadow we will build a snowman.
You'll say, are you married? We'll say, no, man.
But you can do the job when you're in town.
Ever bungee cord jump off the Golden Gate Bridge? Ever jump over 25 buses on a motorcycle that were engulfed in flames? Neither have I, but we do have a true daredevil with us at Disneyland today, and his name is Jaleel White. He's about to take on the biggest challenge of his young life, the Disneyland mountain ranges. Now, kids, this may not be suitable viewing for some of your parents, so please use discretion, okay?
Today, my thrill-seeking friends, we will conquer the amazing mountaintops of Disneyland.
Yeah!
I will be your fearless leader, so there's nothing to be afraid of.
A big Thunder Mountain! Let's go for it!
Don't worry that 5,000 feet of twisted steel awaits us, with curves that deny the fundamental precepts of thermodynamics, and a runaway locomotive careening at breakneck speed.
Yeah! Oh, come on, get going.
Oh, right.
What's the Matterhorn?
Well, Joan and Alan, you can't say it never snows in Southern California.
Yeah, well, I can vouch for that.
From all of us to the rest of the world,
Merry Christmas!
Don't go away. There's more holiday excitement coming your way in the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Artillery consultants of Saudi Arabia wish you
Merry Christmas.
And we are back in Orlando, Florida once again.
Yes, welcome everyone. Hope you're having a wonderful Christmas morning at home.
That's a MetLife blimp shot there. There's the blimp.
There's a shot of the blimp. How do they do that? How do they shoot from
with
there?
With a camera from down on the ground.
It's a wonderful business, television, isn't it?
But that
it?
Was over at the Yacht and Beach Club. I saw some people swimming over there.
Yes. Well, only in Florida.
And
I
meanwhile,
hear the soldiers.
Down on the street, on Main Street USA, we have the toy soldiers coming our way. Some precision marching here.
Mm-hmm. First appeared in the Babes in Toyland. The toy soldiers attack the evil Barnaby, give him a big sliver. Wooden soldiers, of course.
That movie was released in 1961 at Christmas time.
Starring Ray Bolger and one of my favorites,
I'll bet.
Annette Funicello. I followed her from the time she was a musketeer right through her beach party phase. Used to dream she was the girl next door. And finally, no, Joan, once she was on an episode of Growing Pains. Annette Funicello,
right.
Yes, they played the neighbor. She played the neighbor. By then, of course, I was married to Maggie. And...
hey, here are the Disney girls. Now, you can never name the seven dwarfs. Can you name
the Disney girls? Chrissy and Missy and Buffy and Muffy and Tiffany and Tammy and Tootsie and Poopsie and Ruth, I think. I hope I got them all.
Oh, I'm sure that was exactly right, Alan.
Great dancers.
Actually, the Disney girls dance all the time over at the Disney MGM Studios theme park.
They do several shows a day.
They've
got to be in the shape they're obviously in. And you know, these toy soldiers are actually inhabited by musicians playing the instruments live. They're playing through all that wood. Tubas and trombones and Mrs. Claus.
Mrs. Claus with a candy cane in her hand, of course. That's got to be one tired lady right now.
She's on hiatus after today, I guess, for a few months. Remember, only 364 shopping days left till next Christmas,
folks. That's right. She must have some sweet tooth. Look at that. Gingerbread house.
She'll be happy to have Santa home for another year.
The woman behind that man who worked so hard to make all the children happy. Oh, look at all the characters. I see the three little pigs. I see the snowmen back there.
Mm-hmm.
Maid Marian is down there.
Maid Marian, and of course, Robin Hood, who stole from the rich and gave to the poor. Too bad he wasn't running the savings and loans.
Oh, Prince John is down there, and the big bad wolf is down there.
More of Donald's relatives, Gladstone Duck and Grandma Duck in the middle.
Brer Bear, Brer Fox, and Brer Rabbit. And Friar Tuck is right there. Look at him. Over there is Prince John.
Prince John.
Who's not always such a princely guy. He made me kiss his ring yesterday.
Look around for you and see what a world.
We'll be going back to the street with all those smiling
characters.
Childlike faces and... Prince Regis, the Duke of Droll, is down there. Hello, Regis.
Thank you, Alan. Thank you, Joan. Having a lot of fun down here, as always, with a very colorful crowd. New York Giants writer. This kid looks just like the kid in Home Alone, that big hit movie. Penn State, where have I seen you before?
Philadelphia.
What you did to me this year. And look over here, Debbie Gibson wearing Sally Jesse Raphael's glasses. Everybody's here this year. Who's going to win the Super Bowl this year?
Let's go.
Forget it. A lot of football fans here, all of them getting ready for the big bowl games and, of course, for the big Super Bowl game as well over in Tampa. Anybody got a winner for the Super Bowl?
Dolphins!
Take your pick. Well, as you know, nobody entertains as elaborately as Disney. And if you think today's parade is great, wait till you catch Disney Spectacular at the Super Bowl next month. Right now, ABC Sports announces Dan Deardorff, Al Michaels, and who's the other guy? Frank Gifford, yeah. They're going to tell
us. Hi, everybody, and a very Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, and we sure hope you're enjoying Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Parade.
As our little gift to you, we just wanted to remind you to join us on Super Sunday, January 27th, when ABC Sports brings you Super Bowl 25.
That's right. We'll be at Tampa Stadium along with Mickey Mouse and the entire Disney gang. They're putting together an unbelievable Super Bowl halftime show celebrating Disney World's 20th anniversary.
And it's the first ever all-kids halftime show with thousands of kid entertainers, fabulous costumes, huge inflatable balloons, fireworks, and surprises. Even the new kids on the block are in the show.
I think it's safe to say that Super Bowl and spectacle are synonymous.
What's unique about this show and what's fun about it is the entire cast is kids.
Not only do we get to salute 25 years of Super Bowl history, but we also get to celebrate the 20th anniversary of Walt Disney World. It is a tremendous entertainment event.
The costumes are absolutely spectacular.
The floats that these kids are going to perform in front of and around are glitzy and glamorous, and we've really challenged our stage crew and our production staff.
And some very big surprises at the end of the show.
The new kids on the block are a phenomenon. These kids are terrific. They will be participating in our grand finale. It's as big as the opening ceremonies for the Olympics, and I think on Super Bowl Sunday, people are going to be just amazed.
We will rock you.
Yes, it's going to be the most spectacular halftime show in the history of the Super Bowl. That's Disney's Super Bowl halftime show, and boy, what a show it's going to be.
I'm looking forward to it. Happy holidays, everybody. See you at the Super Bowl on ABC.
Stay tuned for Santa and the spectacular finale to the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
You know, you really start to feel like a mouse if you're
here
long
enough. This is what happens after a few years of doing this parade.
Yeah, the ears get bigger. Welcome back. An incredible finale coming up to the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
We've got Santa Claus. We have a musical salute from our courageous troops in Saudi Arabia. Even President George Bush has a special greeting for us this morning.
Yes, and some more excitement coming up. The big guy himself will be here, and not just Mr. Bush, of course. We're talking about, yes, the Claus factor.
And we're looking at this gingerbread men coming down Main Street.
Dancing cookies. There are the snowmen. They better not overheat this morning.
That's right. They can melt right there on Main Street. And dancing Christmas trees. I'll bet your Christmas tree all dances, right?
My, I can't find a good dancing Christmas tree.
Only here in the Magic
Mine
Kingdom.
Mine auditioned once for an MC Hammer video, but didn't get the job. You know, the first Christmas tree was in 1605. That was in Strasbourg, Germany. Began that tradition. And now you can start your own tradition, you know, by getting a living tree.
I think that's a great idea, so you can plant it outside in your yard. Really a wonderful idea.
Walking in a winter wonderland. The weather outside is frightful.
Disney MGM girls. How about Rudolph and
Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Cupid, Donner, and Blitzen.
There you go. All right.
And Rudolph, of course.
Prepared for that one, I can tell. Hey, there are the Glock girls.
Yes,
named,
so called,
of course, because
they play Glockenspiels. Those are the things they're now holding in their right hand. But when they whip those up and start hammering on them with that little mallet, we're talking music. You know, I personally didn't hear enough Christmas music this year until Christmas Day.
It's been wonderful today,
but when you flip the dial on your radio, you love to hear it. There he is.
There he is, the big guy himself. And he's got to be one tired camper right now, huh?
It's good to have Santa be so environmentally responsible, driving reindeer and a sleigh. If more people in L.A. drove reindeer, we wouldn't have that pollution problem. A great
and what a Christmas
a
morning this has been.
Yeah, great Christmas morning.
Right now, though, we've got another very special Christmas treat for everyone watching. Christmas greetings from the President of the United States, followed by a very special Christmas song dedicated to all the families who are separated from loved ones this morning. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
Good morning. On behalf of Barbara and the whole Bush family, it's a great pleasure to wish everyone enjoying this wonderful parade a very Merry Christmas. What a joyful, hopeful day this is for everyone. A day to gather with family and friends and share the warmth of quiet fires and the joyous spirit of the holiday season. But let's remember that there are those watching this morning who are unable to enjoy this special day with their loved ones. The families whose mothers or fathers, sisters or brothers are serving their country in the uniform of the armed forces in the Persian Gulf. To those families whose dinner table is missing a loved one far, far from home, let's remember that the courage, commitment, and sacrifice of these men and women is based on nothing less than a love of country and a desire for world peace. Their mission not only speaks to the spirit of Christmas, but to the hopes of mankind as well. And to those outstanding Americans under the banners of our armed forces, Barbara and I extend warm personal wishes and our sincere gratitude for the sacrifices you make in spending time away from the people who mean the most to you, your families. Words alone cannot describe how proud this president and your country is of each and every one of you. This Christmas, let us pray for peace on earth, for the safe return of all of our military troops, and let us give thanks to the families who wait so patiently. A blessed and joyous Christmas to you all, and an early New Year wish of happiness and harmony to our world. Thank you, and God bless you all.
Rocket laws lead the way for we'd all like to wish you a Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Everything else seems going fine over here. Hopefully we'll be home soon.
Happy Holidays! Oh, yeah!
May your days be merry and bright. And may
the best Very Merry Christmas parade I've seen yet. And from my family, Michael and Jamie and Lindsay and Sarah, we wish you all a very Merry Christmas.
Yes, Merry Christmas, everybody, and thank you for joining us today. We had a wonderful time.
And from my grandparents, Izzy and Willis, way up in Northern Ontario, to my kids, Brandon and Robin in California, and to your family, Merry Christmas, everybody.
From all of us here at the Walt Disney World Resort in Florida, Merry Christmas!
The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. Brought to you by Ultra Pampers, for boys and for girls. Now with leak barriers, two walls of protection that help stop wet and messy leaks for dry and happy babies. And Kissimmee-St. Cloud, Florida, the vacation destination in the middle of Central Florida's best attractions. Location is our biggest attraction. And Johnson & Johnson, where quality products for the American family have been a tradition for generations. Air transportation for the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade cast provided by Delta Airlines, the official airline of Walt Disney World. Delta.